So I'm doing a little bit of a redo of a previous video on how to edit moon photos in Darktable. The old video, I got a couple comments on recently. People were trying to watch it and use it and said, you know, a number of the modules are missing that I used in that video. And that's true. Darktable has changed a lot in the last 8 or 9 years since that video was made. So I'm going to redo it and with the modern tools and everything, and hopefully you guys can get something out of it. Here's a picture that I took of the moon about a month ago during the double taco Tuesday, triple wipe, super blue green moon, whatever that was. And it's loaded in a Darktable. It's a raw file, and let's get to editing it. First things first, I'm liking Sigmoid a lot better these days than Filmic RGB, so I'm going to cut that off, and I'm going to set Sigmoid as my display transform, and then we're going to get it cropped in there. So I'm going to find the crop module, and I'm going to crop this in, let's see, widescreen, I kind of like that. We're going to crop that in there, and make that maybe a little bit bigger, put it down there on that third. That looks a little bit more interesting than the old photo. And now we're going to come in here and kind of increase the contrast and get the exposure up to where we're filling up more of the histogram window up here. I'm also going to check to see if we're clipping anything. And we're not. We're underexposed in the sky, but, it's the full moon, and that thing's way brighter than the surrounding sky. Your camera, especially at a tighter focal length like this, is not going to be able to expose for both without some HDR kind of shenanigans. So that's pretty good. We've got some detail in there, and we've spread this histogram out a little bit better. We'll just pop back into Sigmoid here and check out this contrast slider, kind of see what we've got there. Maybe get some more spread out of that histogram. Next thing I'm going to hit is tone equalizer, and I did a whole video on this that I've put subtitles on it because some people have complained about the background music, and fair enough, I think I had it balanced a little not right in there. I'm working on that, and I've recently discovered audio ducking, we'll see how that fixes things. Next, we're just going to mask this in, just like in that video. So all I did was, and you can watch that video for more like in-depth on this, but I just moved it so we get the mask kind of centered up here, and then use the contrast compensation to spread that out. So we've got more histogram in here to work with. So now I'm going to bring down those highlights a little bit. Maybe try to pop those in a little while leaving the shadows kind of up a bit. All right, there we go. Now that's looking a bit more like we've got something there. I might bring these up a little bit. And the reason why I do this with tone equalizer is it kind of gives me a little bit more of a fine grain control over what I can bring up and what I can bring down. I don't get just two sliders. I don't get just an exposure and a contrast. I can come in here and really get finessed with the contrast. Sometimes on a lunar photo, I will come in here and change the masking either to no or averaged or one of these other settings to see how it looks. Right now it looks okay. We're going to leave it on the EIGF setting, the exposure independent guided filter. Now that we've got like a grayish looking something without any clipping on it or anything, let's start adding in some sharpness and get rid of some of the softness here. To do that, we're going to come in here and find diffuse or sharpen. It's under the effect tab, and I'm just going to pick, I shot this on something without an AA filter, so I'm going to choose the default no AA filter that pops in a little extra sharpness. Then I'm going to come here in the little squares, and I'm going to do a new instance, and I'm going to do lens to blur medium to see how that does, and that kind of knocks out a little bit more of that softness. You know, when you're working with an extreme telephoto lens through the atmosphere like this, you're probably going to need to use a couple instances of this module just to tweak, and you might need to tweak it a little bit to take care of some of that poor seeing conditions or atmospheric kind of boiling and whatnot. There is a local contrast setting in here, but I don't really care for it that much. So we can go under here and go local contrast. And I don't like it as much as the old school local contrast module. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that and then come out here. And is it, where is that? Let's see. Local contrast. All right. There it is. And cut that on and kind of tweak this a little bit. Get more detail in there. And that's just, it's a bit more punchy and a bit more easily tunable than diffuse and sharpen. So I'm going to come in here and tone that. And now we've really got some relief in there. But we do have some noise. So I'm going to find profile denoise. And the way I do this is a two-step process for astronomy photos. We're going to first use the preset wavelets chroma only, and that gets rid of the color noise, but we still got a little bit non-color noise in there. I'm drawing a blank on the word right now. But what I do is I make another instance of this. So I just click square and new instance, and then I'm going to change this to non-local means auto. And I'm going to turn that strength down a little bit, and that kind of knocks out some of that other noise in there. So you really probably should be using two instances of this on dark photos. Even though this is only 320 ISO, just with this, it really helps take care of that. I'm sure the word will come to me in a minute. Next, there is some color there, so I'm going to pop into color balance RGB. I'm going to take the preset of vibrant colors as a starting point. That's not vibrant enough, so I'm going to really crank up the saturation here on these here, because there is some color, and you can kind of get one of those mineral, something in the neighborhood of one of those mineral moon photos. Crank up the vibrance too, and you know, you can kind of do that, maybe not do the highlights so much, but bring up everything. And you can see the difference here from here to here. We're getting a little bit of color in there. This is not advisable on a normal photo, but there is color data here. It's just very not very strong. And likewise, you can make another instance of this if you really want to go nuts and you just want to drag up global saturation again and really get it going. I might reset this one. Let me just drag up global saturation and global vibrance. There we go. That's a bit much. We'll kind of maybe drag that one back a little bit so we get like 150%. You can also come into color calibration and kind of try to balance on some of these areas here if you need to. Theoretically, the moon should be daylight since it's just reflecting sunlight. So you could go under daylight and, you know, what is it? And mess with it there. But I don't really think that works in this case. So we're just going to kind of select one of the white points there. So now we've got kind of a colorful picture. We got rid of the noise. We got some detail in there. Now we want to knock out any chromatic aberrations. So we just search for that module. And you can see it's kind of yellow green here around the edge. So we do green. We're going to increase that radius. And you can see that's starting to go away. I don't want it to go too much. But there you go. And now that's gone. If you really want to get crazy with it, there is a module called Contrast Equalizer. And I would advise cutting off local contrast. And you can leave local contrast on and stop here. And this is probably a decent lunar photo, right? You know, kind of artistic looking. But if you want to come into Contrast Equalizer, you can come in here and mess with these settings. So you've got chroma, so you can adjust the fine color, you know, and the fine details, or the broad color and the broad details. Luminance, so this basically makes your kind of contrast. So you can bring it up, your contrast up in the broad areas and the large areas and the coarse kind of details, or you can go into the fine details and really pump that up. It gives you a bit more control. So I'm going to do that and come in here in edges and bump that up a little bit. chroma, I'm going to go into the big area here and do that. And you can kind of adjust this effect in and out a little bit until you get the desired one. And just kind of comparison, that's what we had. And with this, it really, really makes it pop a lot better, I think. And then, you know, again, this is more of a surrealistic kind of picture. I'm not really going for, like, what my eyes see. You should not try to duplicate reality perfectly. You can't. Anyway, you know, digital photo is just a discrete representation of reality anyway, so you should have some fun, I think. Unless you're shooting photojournalism, and then, you know, please try to stick to reality as much as possible. But we can come in here and adjust that and really get this to pop. I might pop out here into sigmoid and kind of look, get the overall contrast up. You can play with the slew and kind of get some more contrast in the highlights, maybe back it down a little bit. But there you go. How long did that take? Let me look at my timer. How long have we been going? 10 minutes ish. So in 10 minutes, we went from this to this, which looks a little bit better. Let me kind of get those darks down there a little bit. We'll kind of come in here and bring those down. And tone equalizer. There you go. And don't be afraid to go back. There's no like, oh, I've done that module, I can't go back to it. If you make an adjustment and then you need to go back and make another adjustment in another module, nothing wrong with that. Totally okay. You know, there's no like, oh, proper order or proper, you know, set of steps. Do what works best for you. So again, starting point, ending point. I think that looks pretty good. That's something you can put on Instagram or whatever the kids are using these days. I don't know. Anyway, your web zone, your website, social media, and talk about the Double Taco Tuesday triple white blue green supermoon you saw. Let me know if this kind of video was helpful. There were some people saying that they were watching the old one, so that's why I kind of came back and revisited this. If you liked it, let me know. If I got something you didn't understand or I went too fast, let me know. If you don't like this kind of video, I guess, let me know too. I'll probably tell you to, you know, not to watch it, because if you don't like something, why are you watching it? But anyway, thanks again for watching and sitting through it this long, and I will see you in the next one.